on. So we're going to be making a couple different dishes for like the 4th of July barbecue, that kind of thing going. So big, big fan of our country. So shout out to anyone who served in the military. Thank you for your service. And so I think it's a good way to appreciate, you know, get the family together. So we have our hot dogs, but we're trying to stay healthy with this. This is definitely on the pricier side. I'll list the ingredients as an alternative that you can do that's a little bit more budget friendly. But if you can, or if you just want to splurge for the holiday or a special occasion, then go kind of with more of these ingredients. This is gonna be the best nutrition that you can get for your buck. So we have bison is super high in micronutrients. So your zinc, your creatine, not really a micronutrient, but part of what helps your body build. So you can also take it as a supplement, but you can also get it from like bison, right? So your zinc, your phosphorus, your iron for sure, it's gonna be super packed. So it's also gonna be really tasty, right? Healthy, because it's all natural. But even more importantly, what we wanna look for is grass-fed. So that's what we're really looking for, is grass-fed, and like I said, ideally regeneratively sourced. So that's gonna be super high in your omega-3, so anti-inflammatory. So we go in, we hit all this, you know, with the gym, we break down the muscle tissue, we cause inflammation in the body, which is, in the short term, a good thing, but if we have it chronically, then we can really start to have detriment. We start getting achy joints, maybe we don't recover as well. It can even go as far as like our sleep is impaired. If we have it chronically over like a lifetime, that's where you start getting chronic diseases. It's gonna be high in your omega-3s, anti-inflammatory. So it helps to curb all that stuff that we're doing in the gym and just what life puts on you in general. So we have that for our hot dog section. This is gonna be grass-fed beef. This is an ancestral blend. And so basically what they've done is they've added a couple of other special ingredients to it. And what I mean by special is just like stuff that you might not normally have. So in this case, we're gonna have our ground beef like normal, but we're also gonna have beef liver, and we're also gonna have beef heart. So those are gonna be really high in your like vitamin A. It's gonna be really high in CoQ10, which is really, really great for your heart. Iron, again, omega-3s because it is grass-fed. So that is the beef. We're gonna make some burgers out of that one. We have more bison. Again, out of all the different creatures you can get, you got your fish, no legs, you got your two legs, so your poultry, and then you got your four legs, your bison, your beef, your venison, which is essentially a deer. Out of all those different types of animals, even if you get it all natural, you go out and catch it yourself or hunt it, then this is still gonna be the best one. This is the most nutrient packed. So if you have the option, you have the budget for it, or like I said, you wanna splurge every now and then, go with your bison, that's your best one. Venison, we have our bison hot dog, we have our beef hot dog. These are made out of chicken. So again, this one is organic. It's got our little USDA organic seal of approval on there. So it's been rigorously tested and made sure that everything is up to standard. So this is actually a really good one. If we're going by the book, because it's got the little stamp of approval, that this is probably the best one. But again, I trust all these brands, especially the Force of Nature. I've been using these guys for about the past 6 months on and off. We're gonna kind of split these, and we're gonna make like tacos. So Egg Life, it's literally just an egg wrap that you can use, and it actually tastes pretty good. It doesn't taste like an egg white. It just tastes more kind of like a little tortilla. The original flavor, Southwest kind of flavor. Southern Sprouted whole grain wrap. Stick with your whole grains. This is the better way to go. We don't want anything that's like really processed. Your processed carbohydrates are really what mess with you. And I think where a lot of people go wrong, even in people who are highly active, you want to go more with like your sprouted whole grains. If you're including carbohydrates, you could also go with like a root vegetable. So your potatoes, your sweet potatoes would be another way of growing your brown rice and quinoa / lentils. So any one of those would be kind of the carbohydrates I'd recommend. Our little side dish is gonna be sliced up peppers. We got our green, try and get a little bit of color in there, right? Color usually means you're getting more variety of your micronutrients. So we're gonna get a lot of vitamin C, we're gonna get flavonoids, we're gonna get phytonutrients. So these are so nutrient dense, you could pretty much live off of them, right? Couldn't find a bun that I really liked. I'll list some other options that I've used in the past, but take them with a grain of salt, that they aren't as good for you. a lot of times just because it has vegetable oil in it, and vegetable oil is really not that good. It's really high in omega-6, so kind of that flip side of all the omega-3 that we had in that, omega-6 is very pro-inflammatory, so it causes a lot of inflammation, right? So we're gonna keep it a little boring on this end. Both for the hot dogs and for the burgers, we're just gonna use Dave's breath. You got your little stamp of approval there, and you got your omega-3s, right? A decent amount of fiber. You don't wanna have too much, and you know, too little can also cause issues too. Unless you're going strictly carnivore diet-based or a lion diet, then I would encourage you to have some kind of fiber in there. Again, if you have too much, it can really bloat you up and it can be kind of uncomfortable as well. Also get like lettuce leaves and just go no carb or low carb. And so if you're obese or you're a little bit bigger, you have a little bit of trouble keeping your blood sugar even, I would definitely recommend that. But we have our protein puffs. We wanna make sure everyone's having a good time and eating well and feeling well afterwards. A lot of time you go to a party and you're like, oh, it tasted so good. And then you're like, oh dang, I feel horrible. Or I feel bloated, I feel like lethargic, you know, like all kinds of stuff. We want people having a good energy from the time they arrive all the way to the time that they get back home and go to bed, right? They're like, oh, that was an amazing day, I had a great. I went with the sea salt and vinegar, the other options that are pretty good that I've had in the past. Actually, I haven't had the sea salt version, but I've had the buffalo, I've had the chicken and waffles. I thought it'd be kind of an interesting mix if we had like a chicken and waffle, so I felt like this would kind of go with it, kind of get like a savory, salty kind of mix going on. But if you do have a little bit of sweet tooth, I love these guys. You don't necessarily have to go with the turmeric. This is unfortunately the only one they had at the time, but these are coconut based. It's all coconut. And it's another version of a wrap, right? Very low in calories. We're at 70 calories for this. So you can go pretty low on the calorie side on this. So like if you're wanting to, you know, if you're wanting to slim down, I'd say grab your coconut, your chicken sausage, or you can go with your venison, which is a little bit higher in calories, but still not breaking the bank. So, you know, you have one serving of this, so that's gonna be 4 ounces of meat. You're gonna get 24 grams of protein, and then you pair it with this, which is gonna be another one, so you're at 25. That's a standard protein shake there for a lot of people. And you're only gonna be at 240 calories, right? Just wanted to add in there that we have a couple of simple spices. So we have our pink Himalayan sea salt. I actually added another salt to this. I'll list that in the ingredients. It has a little bit of potassium in there. So these are our electrolytes, right? You do a lot of sweating, we're working out, we're doing all kinds of stuff. We want to replenish those electrolytes, so your magnesium, calcium, your potassium, and sodium. So the good thing about this is, with traditional table salt, they actually add like an aluminum oxide a lot of times, or aluminum to it, and it's an anti-caking agent, which is great if you don't want your salt to clump up, but it's horrible if you don't want heavy metals in your body and you don't want a lot of inflammation, right? So I cut that stuff out a long time ago and switched over to pink Himalayan sea salt. You do wanna add something that has a little bit of iodine in there. Make sure you're getting your iodine. It's good for your thyroid health. Thyroid's gonna help your metabolism. It's gonna help keep your energy level high as well. So make sure you're getting some iodine in there. So I have essentially three salts in there. I have my pink Himalayan sea salt, packed full of minerals. That's why it's got so much color in it. Like 22, 23 different minerals. And we have our other salt that has a little potassium. Make sure we're not cramping up, get a Charlie horse in the middle of the night. And it has our, a little bit of sea salt that has iodine combined with it. So again, keeping that thyroid nice and healthy. Otherwise, it's kind of hard to get in the diet. So that's what we got for that. And then we're keeping it simple. We have our black peppercorn. Just gonna grind it up. I don't have it with me, but something else that I'll usually add is garlic. So I have garlic. You can either do cloves traditionally, or you just get like a garlic powder and put that on there. Those are usually my three spices with that. Everybody's usually pretty happy. The salt will actually give it a little bit better flavor. So I always encourage you to put some salt on there. And again, if you're working out hard, you're sweating a lot, then we wanna have our salt in there to replenish that. Okay guys, so we have, that was close, good thing I didn't almost drop everything all over the floor. So we have our organic super green. So basically this is a mix of, I believe, kale, baby char, and baby spinach, all organic. Again, trying to stick with the organic theme. And the reason I keep harping on that, or why I keep saying, you know, this is what I got and why I try to go for it. Organic, you know, a lot of times, and what I used to think of in the past is that, okay, it's just kind of a fancy way. They're just kind of blowing it out of proportion. It's what, you know, kind of people with like an extra, you know, dollar in their pocket will get. But really after I looked into it more thoroughly, they make sure there's no pesticides, herbicides. If it's, you know, in this case, a meat source, they're making sure that They're not eating anything funky. They're not using, you know, if they're eating grass or making sure the grass doesn't have fertilizer on it or like a bunch of like, you know, Roundup and stuff like that. We're getting our good animal source of high quality protein, all the minerals there. We're getting our greens, and then we're getting a little bit more color. We're getting some whole grains with our wraps and our bread, and we're getting the fiber in there. And again, got a little bit of stuff kind of on the fringe that's a little bit more quote unquote processed, but we're still checking the box and making sure everything's good from that standpoint of it's all, you know, healthy based. So a little bit something familiar people can kind of relate to. They're not like, whoa, what is all this stuff? So make them feel a little bit more comfortable where you can. But the good thing about this is all this is really protein heavy, right? So you're getting a lot of your calories from your protein. And if you are getting fat, we made sure it's the good kind of fat that's gonna help you recover. And again, this is kind of more like a little bit on the outskirts of things. We're having a good time with it. We're having good food, tastes good, and we might spend a little bit more, but it's worth it because we're having a good meal with people we care about. And I think that's what, you know, it kind of revolves around. It's like, you know, you can have a healthy diet and everything, but like what really makes, you know, having good fitness and health is like I had the ability to go and, you know, like we got the guys behind us playing basketball. You know, they're playing basketball with their kids, or they're teaching the next generation how to be a better version of themselves, how to be more skilled, how to communicate and work with each other. And then you got your family, like you want to be there for them for the long run. You don't want to just be there for this one occasion. You want to be there for the next 20 barbecues, right? And this is how you do it. You have the good time, you have the good food, and you know, but you're improving your health while doing that. So we're checking all the boxes. We're in a good space. So I'm looking forward to cooking this and showing you guys how to go about it, and definitely doing a personal taste test at the end to, you know, make sure everything tastes just right. But really, you're getting a dinner in for today. But again, hope you guys are having a wonderful 4th of July or just barbecue weekend. And I'll catch you in the next segment here.
Careful with it. We've had this going, so it's nice and hot. As you can see, probably see some fumes coming off of it, but we got this super hot. That's probably like 500 degrees by now. So I'll turn it down. But what we want to do, if you've never grilled before, and this is something you always want to keep in mind, you want to get the grill nice and hot so that it cooks everything really well. But if it's too hot, you'll cook the outside on both sides really quick, but the inside will be kind of raw. So you want to heat it up, put it on high for like 5-10 minutes. Ideally, you have a temperature gauge that you can have on that and see how hot it is. But once you get it nice and hot, put it low. Usually what I'll do, I'll keep one side either hot or medium. In today's case, since I got so much going on, and I'm not cooking like a steak where I can have it kind of pink or even red in the middle. I want to make sure everything's cooked thoroughly. Anytime you have kind of ground, anything that's ground up, so this is all ground up and everything, so everything has been exposed. Whereas like a steak or something like that, really just the outside. So if we cook the outside, we're good. Everything on the inside, it's sterile because it has a layer. Whereas this has all been exposed to quote unquote the elements or like just the environment. We wanna make sure everything's cooked all the way through. So we're gonna turn that temperature down, make sure that heat goes all the way through. So we're gonna keep this at like a medium temperature on one side, and then the other side, either put it on low is what I'll usually do, or if it's a really hot grill, you could even turn it off because we have that carryover temperature. So we kind of like sear one side, get that action going on, and then we'll transfer to the other side, and that will allow it to cook all the way through, make sure that we're not having anything that's pink or uncooked, right? You don't want to make anybody sick. That's a good way to ruin the day. So we're going to make sure that that is all set, and then we'll go through that process. But really, kind of give it a good like 2-3 minutes on the hot side, and then we'll kind of transfer it over. Pick one, you know, I usually pick one as kind of like a sacrificial, and I'll keep cutting into that and checking. I'll be like, hey, that one's mine. I'm the cook. I'm gonna make sure the food tastes good and it's good for everybody to eat. Personally, like I'll have raw liver every now and then, so I'm not too worried about that. But more of like your regular meat, you do want to cook. So if it's like a ground beef, a ground venison, then yeah, your raw liver, if you freeze it and then you take it out, I really think you're okay with it. You can always rinse it off as well if you think something's on the outside. I do encourage that, give it a good rinse. And you can even throw it back in the freezer, right? So I'm not too worried about that, but we wanna make sure, especially as like you got all your guests coming over, we wanna make sure it's cooked. So I'm gonna make sure everything's cooked all the way. And I'll give you guys kind of a good slice to show you what it looks like on the outside as well as the end. Okay. Just a quick word from our sponsors. We don't have any today. It's just us. But who I'd like to thank is the men and women in the past who have served our country. And I also wanted to thank you for watching and taking the time out of your day to view this video. Part of celebrating our freedom, I wanted to extend that to you. And this is free. You know, we have stuff on the website that you do have to pay for, that is part of the service that I've hopefully earned by giving you a bunch of knowledge and stuff that's taken me over a decade to really learn, experience, blood, sweat, and tears. And so this is completely free to you guys. I hope you enjoy it. Excellent food, good nutrition, and like I said, really take today not only to enjoy the barbecue setup that we have going on here, but the freedoms and liberties that we have here in the U.S. and again, just being with your family and friends. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. Ooh, nice little sizzle. Yeah. Oh, shit. Okay, oh man. Ooh, that was a close one. So that one's going on the cool side there. Got that on camera.
I didn't record that.
Okay, cool. Little 4th of July angel hanging out with me today. Little food angel. Got food babies, got food angels. Whew, okay. Okay, we're gonna put that one right there. So we're gonna let that cook for a second. And we're gonna leave that on there for like 2 minutes or so. And we'll give it a good flip. We're gonna go real fast. There you go, so very minimal. And then flip her over. We'll get a little fancy with our flip. Flip up. Come on. Flip over. Yeah, still good. One thing I wanted to point out is like I have our pepper. You can kind of see it in there. Our little bit of pink Himalayan sea salt. And so I just kind of lightly put that on. And so when I go to squish this, it's gonna embed in it, so it's like in the meat itself. Another one here. I think raise your own cattle, raise your own chickens if you can. Get some fresh eggs every day, and you know what's going in them. That's probably the bigger thing. I think we've kind of lost that as a culture of like, okay, we go to the box and we get our food in the box, and then we put it in the box, and then we eat it. Think outside the box, live outside the box, live outside the norm. Like it makes things a lot more fun, a lot more interesting. So I think like go out, hunt your own food, go out and have your own chickens. If you don't want to hunt your own food, have your own chickens, and then you just take the eggs. No one's going to hurt. But you're getting a lot of good nutrients, and you know exactly what those chickens are eating. They're eating the grass, they're eating the insects, and they have a good diet, and you're getting something healthy in you. Guys, so we got our three different dogs in there. So finishing up here with our unboxing on bagging. This is our chicken, this is our beef, and then our bison. So we're gonna throw those guys on next. We're finishing up with our burgers, and cannot wait to dive into these. I'm getting hungry, smells good, and I'm sure it's gonna taste good. Right. Do not touch the grill, it is super hot. Yeah, switching over from side to side, because that side's got a lot of action, this side's a little bit cleaner, so we heated it up, we're gonna bring it down to like a medium temperature, and then this one we are gonna bring up, and that way the heat will kind of funnel over and cook that. So kind of like a low medium slash medium for the hot dogs. We do want to make sure that these are turned a little bit quicker because they're smaller, has a lot more surface area in comparison. So make sure they're getting on a good rotation. We are going to switch over to some actual hand tools for this, so to speak, and make sure they're not getting burned. What I'm kind of looking for, you can see it on this one, start getting kind of a split, and basically that means like the inside's kind of starting to steam up or get real hot and expand to the point that it kind of tears the outside layer of this. So that's at a good point. We're not overcooking it. Really, you should be done cooking all this food 15-20 minutes if you do it right. So short and sweet, have people come in, kind of give them a little bit of a smell, of what's to come, the good meal that they're about to enjoy, and you know, start bringing it off. And they're like, oh man, I see it. They get the anticipation, a little bit of water in their mouth, and then when they bite into it, like it delivers. Like, it's a great, fulfilling meal. Makes you feel good, builds the muscles, and you're ready to rock and roll the next day.
Okay,
here we go. Crunch time.
I'm in a hurry to get things done. Oh, I'm rushing till life's no fun. All I really gotta do is live and die, but I'm in a hurry and don't know why. Don't know why I have to drive so fast.
So there we go. Make sure the grill is off. Safety first. You can keep it open. If you got little kids running around, throw that thing shut. Put some caution tape over if you want, whatever you want to do. But what you have to do is enjoy all this and not drop it. So I'm gonna be real careful as I transfer it over. Ooh. Over here we have a kind of our veggie option. We have our high protein, so we got our different color bell peppers. You can slice them up more. I kind of thought these were fun. You could, you know, kind of lay them out, make a little bit of like a design with it. Kind of slice them all nice and neat if you want to. We have our nacho protein puffs. These are actually really good, super cheesy. And then we have our salt and vinegar protein chips, our wild, going wild. Everything's wild today. Everything is very naturally based, or in this case, kind of organic. Coming back to our whole grains, we have our egg wraps. If we're missing somebody, I'll have to look around and grab them. We have our coconut wraps. We have our Dave's Bread. Oh, there's the other one. And our Southwest. So I assume this is kind of a little bit more like a spicy, maybe like a barbecue kind of flavor. I'm not really sure. We'll have to see. But I always encourage, you know, try something that you haven't before, see how it goes. I think these are probably going to be one of my favorites. So we're just going to kind of make a real quick version of each, and then we're going to dive in.
I'm in a hurry to get things done. I rush and rush until life's no fun. All I really got to do is live and die.
Here's all of our different wraps, and our burgers are pretty straightforward. We're just gonna grab our bread here. Boom. I always kind of do a old-fashioned boat style, so I'll kind of fold the back up, kind of fold the sides in like that. And that way, if anybody falls out, I shove them back in. Or if I want to stick some other stuff in there, I can do that too. Sweet to start off with. Got some good savory going on. A little bit of a crunch factor going with our pepper. Yeah, that's some good stuff, guys. This is pretty good. I think this one's gonna be my favorite. I'll go through and do a little bit of taste test with everybody. See what the cameraman thinks. And we'll put which one we think is the crowd favorite there. So, yeah, bison or beef, probably bison is going to be the best flavor. So burger-wise, if you're like, okay, grandpa's been really good to us this year. Yeah, he, you know, maybe he's like the World War II vet or something like that, or Vietnam or something like that. He's getting the good stuff. We're going to give him probably the bison burger. And the patties are a little small,
right?
But you can make that. You can give grandpa a big 1 pound bison burger. You know, get the whole thing. Pop it on there. You got a big bison burger like that. You know, if you're watching this and you're like, man, you know, like I only have a handful of people coming over for the barbecue today, or maybe you're watching this and it's just you. You can always change your life for the better. And that's, you know, part of what this whole website is about, of like learning what you have the possibility to do. It's literally all in your fingertips and all in your mind, right? If you want to get up and change your life, have an excellent 4th of July, and then on the next day, go out, go for a run, go work out, start that nutrition, start that momentum, start that snowball chance in hell of maybe having a better future, and start an avalanche with it. Like, throw everything to the wayside and be like, hey, this little snowball chance in hell that I'm throwing in, I'm gonna start building off of it until it can just roll right through hell and just keep going. And you get to the point where it transitions from, you know, doing all the stuff with all your nutrition and doing all the stuff with the workout, and it starts giving it back. You get in what you put out, right? So if you're putting out 110% effort, you might not see it right off the bat. It might take you 4 weeks, it might take you 8 weeks. If you haven't done this for a while, if you haven't ate right, if you haven't worked out, it might take you 3, 6, 12 months. I don't know. I don't know how far along, you know, kind of the opposite side of the tracks that you're on, but it's never too late to change things around, to change your life for the better and get back on the path. And in doing so, it gives you the confidence that if you did it once, if you did one day right, if you did one meal right, you can do the next one right, and you can do the next one. And then the next thing you know, you're on that path and you're going, you know, Mach 5 with it, and no one and nothing is getting you off of that. And your life is that much more fulfilled because you're not held back by your past, you know, past in general, but also your past inabilities, your past insecurities. You know, you build up that self-esteem, that self-worth, that self-confidence, and the world is your playground at that point. You can do whatever you put your mind to and you put your will behind. So keep that in mind when you're putting your little meals together, you're putting your barbecue for everybody else together, that you're also still keeping yourself on track. Keep yourself on track, you emanate that energy that you're building up in you, and you start putting it into other people close to you, and they start bouncing it back, and it's just an energy field, and it's something special. So like I said, I hope you guys enjoy this. Food's, you know, excellence, a highlight of life. You go out to the people like, let's go to the restaurant, let's have this party, we're gonna have this cake, we're gonna have, you know, what have you, but food is it's a crucial part of life, right? Can't live without it. So enjoy it and have it get back to you, right? Enjoy the meal, enjoy the family time, growing the body in and outside the gym with good nutrition, stacking with all the hard work and effort and fortitude, due diligence. Oh, don't drop the food. You got 5 second rule, or have the dog come and grab it. But having that good food complements that hard work, right? Okay guys, so we got all of our food here. We got our different kind of meals. We have our tacos, we have our burgers, and then we have our hot dogs, right? So hope you guys have a wonderful 4th of July. This is just one segment and a portion of the website. So we have a lot of like cookbook videos, got a lot of recipes, and overall nutrition, just kind of going over like how to build the body, how to recover, how to help with sleep, getting into other portions of just like quality of life. How do you improve that? So we want to have a good, you know, recovery outside of the gym and a good quality of life as well. So in addition to that, we also have the workout section that you can check out here. It's kind of like a quick overview. So we have it all the way from beginners all the way to advanced. If you want to be like a fitness model, or you want to try and be like a high caliber athlete, or just somebody who, like, you know, you're trying to hit that pinnacle of whatever your body is capable of, we have that for you. So we have, you know, a little bit of a, you know, beginner, intermediate, and advanced, and so you can scale it up however you need to. If you're already halfway there, you can start the intermediate section and go there. And we just have like an open library as well. So if you're like, hey, I don't necessarily need a program, but I want to kind of get an idea for where I should go with it, then we got that too. So a lot of things on the site that you can check out. I encourage you to look into it. If you haven't subscribed to the email list, go ahead and do that below. And again, you guys can always reach out either on social media, on YouTube, on Facebook, on Instagram. On YouTube, I'm gonna be under David Todd Miller. On Facebook, I'm at David Miller Fitness, Fitness Model. And then I'm David Miller Fitness on Instagram. Again, email-wise, I'm gonna be info@davidtoddmiller.com. And if you're out in California, throw something at me, Southern California. And if you're in the neighborhood, come out for a bite to eat, and we'll go from there. But again, hope you guys have a wonderful 4th of July holiday, and I'll catch you in the next video.